What's up, you guys? You're watching Sergio's Secret. Before I get started with today's video, if you can please give this video a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button. I post a video Monday through Friday on contemporary and designer fashion, so make sure to subscribe so you can't miss any of my uploads, guys. And also, all the links for everything will be linked down below, so if you are ever inquiring about any of these items, I'll leave it down below for you guys so it's really easy for you to navigate. And without further ado, let's do my favorite tote bags under $400. For me, definitely in the month of April, I definitely want to focus more on core. Really in the first segment of April, for April 1st to the 15th, I'll be talking a little bit more about core items. And then towards the end of the month, there will be more kind of out there videos. But you know, with Sergio's Secret, there's a lot of different types of videos going around. And so today I decided to do a bread and butter video, a video if you are getting into totes, maybe you want to add another core tote into your collection. I have talked about some of these bags on my channel before, so I just wanted to say that this video is for the person that wants a clean cut classic tote under $400. So I have 12 options for you guys. I think that all these are really great. They were curated, and let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna move to the side right over here, and so I can insert pictures of the item. Searching for this video was actually pretty fun. I found a new tote that I didn't even know that was out in the market. I actually kind of fell in love with it just seeing it online, and I do really, really, really wanna see it in store. So the first tote that I recommend under $400 is gonna be by Coach. And this is the Coach Tyler Carryall Tote. This one comes in at $350, and oh my god, it comes in gray, it comes in black, and it comes in white, and it comes in kind of like a peachy color. Normally, I'm a fan of gray handbags. For me, I kind of find it hard to style gray bags. I don't know if that's just me. I've had gray bags in the past, like tote bags, like that little pull-in one that you can kind of see peeping right there. That one, I do find it pretty easy to style, but actual true gray bags are hard to style. But I do really love it in this gray color. Like, look at it. I think it is so pretty. I like how clean, minimalistic. For me, what I like is the glazing around the bag. I like that it's a bit more round. It's not really kind of more of a feminine touch. I love that you incorporate the dog tag, and then you have a little bit of the C and ruthenium hardware. And also what I like about the bag is that on the inside, it doesn't have any Coach monogram. I know some Coach totes on the inside have the monogram. I personally prefer it just to have just a regular kind of colored lining. It could be kind of a color blocking moment, or it could be the corresponding color. This one appears that it has more of a maroon look to it on the interior, so I like that it kind of does have that color blocking aspect to it. And I think that this is a really great tote. I have not seen this tote in person, so if you want to get something that's very core, I think this one's really great, and this one can fit a 13-inch laptop. So the first one's gonna be the Tyler Tote by Coach, especially in this gray color. Normally, I find it hard to style gray, but I do my bag in person in gray. It looks like a beautiful tote. And like I said, I have not seen anybody carry this tote as of yet. The next two totes that I'm gonna be talking about are from Dagny Dover. If you don't know what Dagny Dover is, what are you doing with your life? Dagny Dover is a handbag brand that does things for the everyday person, for the everyday guy, for the everyday girl, or whatever you identify as. They are probably the best out there that has compartments, and they think about the working person. And for me, I have been a big fan of Dagny Dover for almost 2.5 years. I have quite a bit of Dagny Dover items in my collection. I have two totes to show you. The first one is currently on sale, so hopefully by the time this video is up, it is still currently on sale. It is the Dagny Dover Signature Legend Canvas Tote. And this one's gonna be a coated canvas. I have seen this tote in person. The only thing is that it's a very stiff tote. On the handles, it doesn't have any hardware, so they do stick up. But what I like about these handles is that they're kind of malleable. You can kind of work with them. If you have to kind of move them on the side, if you have to shove it under a plane, if you have to shove it under a train or a bus or your car or your trunk, those handles will not really wear because they're kind of made to kind of be beat around. On the outside, it has a little bit of a D-ring, so you can put maybe a hand sanitizer, you can put maybe your little work ID, whatever you need. And then on the inside, it has a padded lining for your laptop. For me, I just got a Dagny Dover padded laptop, so it is kind of that same material. And I just like that you can put your water bottle. It has a little section to put your keys in there. And this one sold for $159, but it was $265. So right now it's currently on sale for $100 off. I think that this is a really great one if you just want a work tote that you can beat up, that you can destroy, and that you can literally, you can do anything you want with it, and it will hold up pretty well. And the hardware on this one is gonna be with gold hardware, and the zipper is pretty nice. It's pretty smooth, and it doesn't really move around a whole lot. And so I just wanna recommend this one, especially if you don't coated canvas, you don't want leather, maybe you're a vegan. I think that this is a really great one, and honestly I would just go for the classic black one, but I know that it does come in another color. The other one that I have is going to be the large Allen leather tote by Dagny Dover. This one is going to be a full leather handbag. This one comes in at $345, and kind of the same concept as the other one. It's going to have your laptop sleeve, it's going to have your keyring holder, it's going to have everything. For me, I would go for the black one. It's black on black hardware versus the other one being black with gold hardware. It has a pocket in the back so you can put your cell phone in it. The handles does move around. It's not going to be where they kind of stick up, kind of like the canvas one, where you can still kind of move them around, but they usually stick up. For this one, you can put the handles down, and this one is going to be a little bit more on the taller side. Lining on this one is going to have kind of like a camel lighting, and it has a spot for your phone, for your pencils, for your whatever you need to. This literally has every compartment, so if you do want the classic tote bag for work, especially these last two options from Dagny Dover, I think you can never go wrong with. They are made to go. If you're in school and you want a sophisticated tote, I think the Dagny Dover ones you cannot go wrong with. Well, honestly, any of them in this video. I wanted to make sure that it's a very core-based video, but Dagny Dover is definitely underrated. And I don't really see a lot of people talk about Dagny Dover. On top of here on my handbag wall, all I have is a bunch of Dagny Dover handbags. I have them in handbag stands. And I think that Dagny Dover does not get enough love here on YouTube. And I have a video on Dagny Dover that I posted about a year ago. So if you do want to check it out, I'll leave a link down below where I talk a little bit more about the brand. Or maybe you're into a backpack or maybe other items from Dagny Dover. I'll make sure to leave a link down below. But I think Dagny Dover can never go wrong with. Definitely not your typical kind of like Coach, Troy Burch, Kate Spade, but it is still pretty well known. And I've been seeing Dagny Dover being worn a little bit more here in Dallas, but Dagny Dover can never go wrong with. Next one, I believe I have not mentioned on my YouTube channel, and it's a brand that I've actually been starting to grow and like within the last 8 months. I kind of am very particular about things, so that's why I said 8 months. It's gonna be the MZ Wallace Metro Tote, and this one comes in at $225. So let's say you already have a Longchamp bag, or maybe you want something a little bit different than a Longchamp bag. I think that this MZ Wallace Metro Tote, it is nylon. The nylon on this one is gonna be a lot more softer. Definitely Longchamp has more of a kind of stiffer feel to it. It feels very stiff on the hand, but whenever you touch MZ Wallace nylon, it's very malleable. It kind of moves around a little bit more than the Longchamp versus it's a little bit more stiff. I'm gonna recommend the black on black one. What I like about the Metro Tote is that back pocket, it has a zipper at the bottom. So if you are traveling, you can open that zipper at the bottom of the tote and you can put your luggage through it, or you can just close the zipper at the bottom and you can use it as another pocket to put in your cell phone, maybe your cards, your keys, whatever you need to. With a pouch on the inside that you can actually fold it in. And so this is a really travel friendly bag. Put this on your carry-on, your check-in luggage, and this is just a nice tote. Maybe you want a beach bag, maybe you want a work bag, maybe you just want to have different looks when you're traveling. I think that the MZ Wallace Metro Tote, you can never go wrong with. It comes in a bunch of colors, a bunch of sizes, a bunch of variations, but I just think that the classic Metro Tote, you can never go wrong with. Wallace, like I said, is another brand that does not get a lot of love here on YouTube, and this one does have a zipper on the inside. So, you know, sometimes the Longchamp ones, the Longchamp bags just have a little pocket in them. If you want a nice actual zipper pocket, I think the MZ Wallace is a really great one. I have been seeing people kind of go for the MZ Wallace versus the Longchamp one. I think that they're both really great choices. I will have Longchamp on this list in a second. The Wallace Metro Tote's a really great one. I know in New York and up north, they're very, very popular. Here, they're popular here in the South, but they're not super, super popular. I definitely feel like maybe Longchamp is takes more of the lead in the market here when I see nylon bags. But I will say that MZ Wallace is a pretty great choice. This would not be a Sergio's Secret video if I did not mention Troy Burch. I think Troy Burch does really great totes. So I'm gonna quickly go through the Troy Burch totes because I do talk about Troy Burch quite a lot on this channel. The first one is gonna be the classic Saffiano Robinson tote. Troy Burch has done this variation of a tote for many years. Every couple years, she kind of brings out a new version. If you just want the classic Saffiano tote to fit, particularly two sizes, there's one that's $298, which that one's a bit more on the smaller side, but then there's one that's $348, which is that's the one that I would go for. The one that's $348, I just find that it fits a lot more. It's a lot more versatile, and I like that on the inside, you can put your computer, you can put your cell phone, maybe you can put more of the important things. Dip it up, and you still have compartments where it's very easy to reach for it. So I think if you want the classic Saffiano tote, I think a classic Saffiano never goes out of style. You can never go wrong with. I think that the Troy Burch one is a pretty great choice. And like I said, there's a $298 version. I definitely do prefer the $348 version versus the $298 version. I just like that it's a little bit more bigger. I think it's a little bit better to travel with, and I think it's more better if you're definitely, if you're gonna use it more as a work bag where you have to carry laptops and folders. I think the other one's a little bit more of a good everyday style. The next one is gonna be the Tory Burch McGraw leather tote, and this one comes in at $398. It comes in a lot of color. My favorite color in McGraw collection is gonna be Tamarisu, T-I-R-A-M-I-S-U. It's kind of like a kind of brown, kind of like a browny kind of color. I really like it because it's very versatile. This color can go all year round. You can wear it right now in spring, summer, fall, and winter. She's done the McGraw tote in many variations throughout the years. I don't think you could ever go wrong with the McGraw tote. For me, the reason why I like the McGraw tote, because you incorporate that little TT logo on it, but I like how it's very seamless. It doesn't have any metal. It doesn't really have any hardware. This one, it doesn't really have any compartments on the inside. So if you do just want a classic open tote, for me, I love a good open tote where it has no compartments or anything, but then I also like totes that have compartments. I like a little bit of the best of both worlds. If you just want a very classic Tory Burch tote with no compartments or anything, I mean, it does have a zipper on the inside, but that's about it. But it does have a clasp to at least close a tote. This one is a very kind of more on the casual side when it comes to totes, but do not get me wrong, I still really like the Tory Burch McGraw leather tote. I just wanted to go ahead and mention it. McGraw is one of my favorite collections when it does come to Tory Burch. Next tote I actually own right here, and it is going to be the Tory Burch Perry tote. The reason why I like the Perry tote a lot is because it kind of has the best of both worlds of the Robinson and the McGraw. This one just has a main zipper pocket, but it doesn't have really other compartments in it. It's more of an open tote. And so for me, that's what I like, is that McGraw just has a little bit more of a smaller zip here, but then the Robinson has like a lot of compartments. And I like how this one, it incorporates a middle compartment that I could put my laptop in, but then it's also a very free tote. I definitely love the color blocking on it. I love the black. I love kind of like the brownie color. And then I love the red cliche on it. And then the hot stamping wort and the Tory Burch. I love the glazing on it. I've had this bag for about a year, and I want to say 2 or 3 months. And so it's holding up really well. There's literally practically no wear on it. I am pretty hard on my totes for the most part. And so if you do want kind of like the best of both worlds for a Tory Burch tote, I think that the Perry tote you can never go wrong with. And every season she has a very nice and fun variations of the Perry tote. And then it also comes in a fun, nice crossbody version. So if you do want maybe more of a smaller bag, the Perry tote in the smaller size, it's pretty great. But I think out of all the Tory Burch totes, I think that one is my favorite one. And there's a reason why I have it in my collection. Guys, they're doing construction outside of my apartment, so I'm sorry, I can't control that. I wish I could. I wish I could be like, can you be quiet for a couple of minutes and then you can go back or maybe take a lunch break, but the show must go on. And so the next tote, like I said, I talked about the MZ Wallace tote. The other one that you can never go wrong with is the Longchamp Classic Nylon tote. I have this, a lot of my friends have this, my mom has it. Comes in at $145. They also have a 145 one is gonna be more of a stiffer kind of nylon. And this one is gonna be the classic one where you can fold up. I think you can never go wrong with this. I think even when people only have designer handbags in the collection, for me, I have contemporary and designer, but even people that have designer handbags in the collection, they at least have one Longchamp tote because it's that handy, it is that useful, and it's just a absolute staple in everybody's collection. I feel like everybody needs a Longchamp tote in their collection, just because it is so versatile and it is pretty easy to travel with. But I will say there's another version where the nylon is a little bit more luxe feeling, I would say, and it is Longchamp No Way version. And so the one that I'm gonna recommend is gonna be the one with the strap. I actually have this in my collection. The reason why I like this one is because you have kind of like the top handle on the crook of your arm, but it also has the longer strap on it that you can carry as a crossbody and as a shoulder bag. So for me, I just love how versatile it is. That strap does make a big difference for me at least. And so maybe if you don't want a tote that doesn't have a strap on it, I think that the Longchamp No Way is gonna be a really great, it is gonna be a better alternative. I like that you have versatility. A girl loves options. You guys already know that. I love versatility a lot. So I feel like that's why I definitely prefer the other one. It is gonna be a little bit more than the classic 145 style. But if you do want more versatility, I think it's better in the long run to go for that one. I have the classic one, and then I have the black on black No Way version. I love both, but for my black on black version a little bit more. And so those are the ones that I'm gonna recommend. I'm recommending the classic Le Pliage, but I also kind of gave you an alternative if you do want kind of a step up from the classic Longchamp. Next handbag that I'm gonna be mentioning on this list is going to be from Marc Jacobs. and it is going to be the Marc Jacobs The Tote Bag. I have talked about this ever since I purchased it. I think it's finally been a year since this bag has finally came out, and it's been such an essential in so many people's wardrobe, including mine's. It comes in a bunch of sizes now. When it first came out, it came in two sizes. It comes in this medium size, it comes in a smaller size, and then it comes in a larger size. The smaller one is gonna be 150, this one's gonna be 175, and then the larger one is gonna be 195. So what I love about this tote, I have a full review on it, I will leave it linked down below. I'm not gonna go too further into detail because I do talk about this tote quite a lot. It has a zipper, it has a strap, you can wear a crossbody, shoulder bag, top handle, crook of your arm, canvas, especially that's not coated. I definitely do prefer to get more of a neutral color than the classic black one, but I just think it's a really great one. It has a zipper compartment on the inside. The bag is very, very versatile, very tote friendly, and especially if you are looking to get your first tote, or maybe you don't want, you know, a classic Tory Burch tote or a Longchamp tote, I think this is another great alternative. And they also come in leather versions now, and they are going to be under the $400 price point. So if you do want something that's a little bit more out there, something that's a little bit more fun, I definitely do think that this is a great option. But at the end of the day, I still think this is a classic tote bag, and I do see Marc Jacobs still going heavy with this bag for at least the next 2 to 3 years. It's really stuck with them, and I really feel they're going to be sticking with this going forward. So the Marc Jacobs The Traveler Tote, I definitely do recommend, and the color that I have is going to be in slate green. The next tote that I'm going to recommend, guys, is going to be from Kate Spade. Kate Spade is a brand that I don't really talk a whole lot. I will be making a Kate Spade video in the month of April, but the handbag that I'm going to be recommending from Kate Spade is going to be the All Day Large Tote. And for me, what I like about this tote is that it is black, but I like the contrast of the stitching. I think the black, like more kind of like a baby pink or kind of like a white stitching. I think it's a nice pop of the stitching on it. I think it's still a classic black tote, but I do little like the little bit of the details of a different color of the stitching. On the inside, it does have another color in it, so I like that you can see yourself, because sometimes when a tote is black on black, it's kind of hard to find yourself, especially at night. So I like that this Kate Spade All Day Tote, it does have black on the outside and it has a pop of color on the inside, and then it also has a little bit of a clasp that you can close on it. This one does remind me a lot of the Tory Burch McGraw Tote. The only difference is this one is going to be coming at 228 versus 398. It's going to be a tad bit smaller, but you can still fit quite a lot of stuff. It comes with a pouch as well. The pouch on the black one is gonna be a maroon one. And so I do like that for 228, you get a classic tote, wipeable material, a different colored interior on the inside, and it comes with a removable pouch. For me, that's what I love for it. It's very nice, it's very versatile. And I think Kate Spade does do a nice kind of everyday tote. A couple years they kind of redo one. The last one that they did had kind of like a suede material on the inside, and I didn't really like it as much, and I definitely do prefer the material on this one because it's more kind of like a Saffiano material, which is a lot more easier to clean, versus kind of like their older version had more of a suede feel and it was more harder to clean over time. So I will say, if you love Kate Spade, if you do like that feminine band, the All Day Large Tote from Kate Spade, you can really never go wrong with. So I am gonna recommend that. And I'm so sorry about the noise, guys. The last tote that I'm gonna recommend, guys, under $400, is gonna be no other, guys. I save one of the best options for last because this is one of my favorite totes of 2021. And it is going to be the Tote Far Tote. I will say this one is a little bit more harder to get your hands on. You definitely have to be signed up for their emails. You definitely have to wait for it. This is one of the hottest bags in 2021. So a video on the hottest handbags for spring and summer under $500. I made that video. I'll leave a link down below if you want to check it. This is one of the ones that I mentioned. I got mine in December. It's been holding up super well. What I love about the Tote Far bag is that it is popping. It is an it bag, but I like that it has no hardware. It goes with absolutely everything. I love the TC, but you can kind of give it a no branding look to it. It is vegan leather, so for all my vegans out there, you can participate and get this handbag. And what I love is that it's just very nice and it's user friendly. It has large straps, you can carry as a crossbody and a shoulder bag. It does have a pretty generous pocket in here where you can actually fit quite a bit of stuff. It is pretty deep, so That is the only compartment is the zipper, but honestly, I just love this bag so much. I think it is so versatile. I think it goes with absolutely everything. And this is another wipeable material. Basically, all the bags that I mentioned on this video are gonna be very user friendly. You can literally spill stuff and you can go through the gigs with it. They can be good women's too. You can treat them, throw them on the floor, put them in cars, you know, go through the entire gigs with them. Do whatever you have to do, girl. And they will hold up really well. And I think that all these are classic replenishment style handbags that you can never go wrong with. Your bread and butters, the one that you can rely on, the ones that are good women, the one that be like, oh my God, I remember all the memories and all the crazy things I put through my Tofar tote, my Perry tote, my Marc Jacobs tote. They were a good woman to me because they hold up so freaking well. I've had the Tofar tote not too long ago. And let me tell you, this girl has been through the gigs, girl. She's seen better days since I purchased her, but she's still holding up. And Miss Telfar says she's still my ride or die, so I'm gonna still be a ride or die for her. So it's gonna be the last tote that I recommend. It's gonna be more on the harder side to get. Everything else is very relatively available. You can go in like at Nordstrom websites and you can buy them. This one is gonna be a little bit harder to put your hands on. And if you do wanna know a little bit more on Telfar, I have a full blown video on Telfar as well, which I will leave a link down below for you guys. But yeah, guys, I think that all 12 of these totes, you can never go wrong with. Clean cut classic and your bread and butters that you can always rely on. So I would definitely love to hear your thoughts and your opinions on these totes. Do you like them? Do you not like them? I mentioned some that I already have or that I've already talked about. And then I mentioned new ones like the MZ Wallace, the Kate Spade tote, and the Coach Tour as well. So I would definitely love to hear your thoughts and your opinions. And if you have any tote recommendations under $400, leave it linked down below, because my subscribers and me personally want to know what's new, what's out there, and what are other people recommending, because I definitely want to hear it down below. Thank you so much for watching this video. I love and appreciate each and every single one of you, especially if you made it towards the end of this video. I just want to say thank you so much. All the links for everything will be down below, and I'll see you guys on tomorrow's video, because I post a video Monday through Thursday on contemporary and designer fashion. So make sure to subscribe so you can never miss one of these videos and you can keep up with the fantasy. Bye guys, and thank you so much for watching this video. I love each and every single one of you.